that today we will learn about the SpringBoot basics. In the basics, we will see how can we create Hello World application. To create the Hello World application, for that, which project we have to create in the SpringBoot. In that, I will show to you. First of all, I am telling you about that. First of all, we will create like a SpringBoot Mirror project. In that, in the Mirror project, after the creating a Mirror project, and then we have we will add the all of dependencies. Okay, like this, we have to create and we will run a program. Yeah, now we will start the SpringBoot is a lightweight framework that takes most of the work out of the configuration Spring-based applications. Now you will learn how to use SpringBoot starters, opinions, and executable jars file structure to quickly create Spring-based applications. I will guide you through setting up and running SpringBoot applications, simple Hello World app, and a slightly more complex Spring MVC RESTful web service application. And I use SpringBoot version 1.5.2. Okay, for my application example, I recommended you use 1.5.2 or higher, but the examples should work for any release after the 1.5.2, any other. But I am telling to you, if you will use the less than the 1.5, and then maybe your application cannot be worked. So I will suggest to you, or I will recommend to you, whenever you will run your application during that time, you have to add the version more than the 1.5.2. After the adding the 1.5.2 or 1.5, and then your application will be run easily. Either it can be make an error. Okay. So you have to use the 1.5.2 at least. Okay. Now we will see. You should be comfortable using the Java in that. Okay. Java means Java Development Kit version at version 8 means JDK 8. You will also need to be familiar with the Eclipse, IDE, Maven, and Git. And for that, what kind of software you have to install in your PC? Like a JDK for the Windows, Mac, and Linux, and Eclipse also, and for Windows and Mac and Linux, Apache Maven for Windows, Mac, and Linux, Git for Windows, Mac, and Linux. Now get started using SpringBoot starters. Starters are a big part of the magic of SpringBoot, used to limit the amount of manual dependencies, okay, and the configuration that you have to do. If you are going to use SpringBoot effectively, you should know about starters. A starter is an essential set of dependencies, such as a Maven form, that are specific to the type of application the starters represents. Okay, as we have discussed about the form, whenever we will create application, after the creating application, in that we will open the form file. After the opening the form file, and then I will add the all of dependencies. How can we add the dependencies? These are things I will add. All starters are used to name the condition SpringBoot starters, where XYZ is the type of the application you want to build. Here are some popular SpringBoot starters. SpringBoot starters web is used to build RESTful web services using Spring MVC and Tomcat as the embedded application container. Okay, so we have to use this one, SpringBoot starters web. Okay, these dependency I will also add in my form file. Okay, and then I will show you. Okay, SpringBoot starters jersey. SpringBoot jersey. Starter jersey is an alternative to SpringBoot starter. web that uses a Apache jersey rather than a Spring MVC. Okay, whenever we have to add the Tomcat, for that we can use the jersey, starter jersey. Okay, and Spring Boot starters JDBC Spring Boot is used for JDBC connection polling. It's based on Tomcat JDBC connection boot implementation. Okay. Whenever we have to do the database connectivity, during that time we can use the JDBC. Now we will see auto configuration. Okay. If you let it Spring will use its at the rate enable auto configuration annotation to automatically configure your application. Auto configuration is based on the jars in your class path and how you will define your wings. Okay. Whenever we will create our class, in our class, after using these all of things like add the rate enable auto configuration and these all of things. Okay, and then it can be automatically run our project. Means whatever dependencies or whatever things we are having the requirement, it will auto get. And Spring Boot uses the jars. Okay, you have specified to be parents in the class path to form an opinion about how to configure certain automatic behavior. For example, if you have the H2 database jar in your class path and have configured no other data sources bins, then your application will be automatically configured with an in-memory database. Spring Boot uses the way to define bins to determine how to automatically configure itself. For example, if you annotate your JPA bins with @ entity, then Spring Boot will automatically configure JPA such that you do not need a persistence.xml file. Okay, now we'll see hello world. How can we create this thing? Now you are ready to start working directly with Spring Boot. Example in this section are based on a simple application called Hello Spring Boot. I encourage you to work through the application development example with me. Okay. First of all, we will see how can we create the main project. Okay. Now we are opening our Eclipse. As I have shown to you, to create the main project like this, so we can create. And then another way also we are having is the. Okay, these are the things we have created. And now it is showing to you in Eclipse or Spring Boot, we have to go like this. As we have opened our Eclipse for STS, after the opening is the Spring Boot, and then we have to click over a new, and then now we are not getting any option to create a new project. For that we have to go on the other. Okay, after the going on the other, here we have to type the new one like this way. Okay, after the typing this new one, and then you can see here new one project is. So here, and then we have to click over there. Yes, I have clicked over there, and then it is going to be create a project, new Maven project, and then okay. Now we have to write here the group ID, anything we can write. Okay. Now we have to pass the artifact ID. Artifact ID is nothing, that is the project name. Spring Boot help. I am writing this Spring Boot help the project name, and then copy this thing and paste here. Here we can write the description, anything. hello world, anything we can write here. After that, we have to click on finish. And I can see here, our project is created here. Yeah, you can see this one is our project. Okay. Like this, we have to create your project. Okay. These all of these you have to add like this way. And here is the showing our. I am using the following setting for that. Hello SpringBoot application, group ID, artifact ID, and version and package also we can add here, but I did not add. And click the finish. Like this way you can get. Okay. After the adding these all of things, and then we have to go inside the com file. Okay. We have to open this com file. After the opening this com file, and then we have to add dependencies here. Now we will add the only these two dependencies here, which we are having here. Now I have added these all of these. Now you can see here, yeah, I am using the SpringBoot version as a 1.5.2. Okay, and then which dependencies I was showing to you, starter, this dependency I am using here, the starter web. Okay, as I have added this, and then we have to create a package here. SpringBoot app I have taken here, and then we have to create a class here. Spring control class I am taking here. Now you can see here, the class has been created here. Okay. After that, first of all, we have to update our project. You can see here, which error we are getting here. This error will be removed. Even and update. I can see here, as I have updated our project, after that which error we were getting here, this error, that error has been removed automatically. Now we have to come inside the controller class. After that we have to move here, and then these all of these we have to add here. Now I am copying the all of these. And then this is the controller, and enable auto configuration as I have shown to you there. And so we have to import. Now we have write this program, but we will continue this class, this session into next class.